Are you interested in buying yourself some anime or manga merch? Some amazing hoodies, shirts with your favorite character on it? From JoJo's Bizarre Adventure to Kimetsu no Yaiba, Dragon Ball, My Hero Academia, One Piece, Tokyo Ghoul, Fairy Tail, Bleach, Haikyuu, and many others. Go click the link in my description box now, and get some awesome discounts from 20% up to 68% off. They offer you free shipping as well. So, what are you waiting for? Link in the description.
Full stop. And then there he was. Lying helplessly on top of his cold mattress, the moonlight phasing through the slight opening in his windows. He felt the shivers running up his spines, the cold irradiating from the weather crawling up inside his heart. His heart felt cold. The green-haired boy stared up at the ceiling, his mind traveling at a speed of millions per hour. Hearing the subtle ticks of clocks as he waited, and waited. He couldn't understand the emotions his heart decided to come up with when he saw the sight of Katsuki's calm expression as he talked about random topics to Kirishima. He didn't know what infuriated him more, Katsuki being absolutely unbothered by the sharp glares aimed towards him from Deku, or how the green-haired boy had noticed that the two best friends had better dynamics. In all perspectives. Bakugo had a short temper, everyone knew that. He calls everyone shitty nicknames his brain could come up with and scowls at them if they get on his nerves, which happens a lot of times. If he really wanted, he could have blown them off to the ends of Earth, but sadly that would just be frowned upon in all states. The blonde never had any friends before coming to UA, the leeches he was accompanied with in junior high only stuck by him for popularity because of his quirk. It was different now, he had real friends. Bakusquad as a matter of factly would try their best to make sure Bakugo felt like he fit in. It's named after him, basically. No matter how much Katsuki would deny it, he had a soft spot for them. Most for Kirishima. The redhead has been the most persistent person he's ever met, and isn't terrified to make a conversation with him like others do. What pleased Bakugo the most from him, is that he knows when the blonde needs space, and when he shouldn't ask questions. Kirishima understands his dark acidic humor, added with the undying patience he has. Quite remarkable to say the least. Ever since the greenette and Katsuki decided it was the end to their pathetic little misunderstandings, they've been able to start reading one another like an open book. Transitioning sure was hard at first, they've fought almost every single day, which was tiring but both of them had graved it inside their head, that the more they spent time together, the longing of each other whenever they parted ways would be harder to maintain. They were like two hedgehogs that cuddled up to each other on a cold night, when they got too close they seemed to hurt each other more because of the sharp spikes, but when they split further away they were left shivering to bits. Both of them had to take this in the harsh way, and figured they were just never meant to be friends, or more than that. What they didn't take into mind was that there were two other possibilities. That the hedgehog's spines only hurt when they aren't relaxed, or that the creature could choose to cuddle up with another animal. Take a turtle for example, they have shells that can protect them from the spikes. What? What do you mean by that? You're always clinging onto my ass like a lost puppy and asking questions that you know the answer to. Fuck, you know how I need my space. Aizuku decides to be petty about the situation, raising his chin up and smugly commenting something in a challenging tone. Well, I'm sorry if my presence bothers you that much, Kachin. It's like I was the one who insisted on hanging out with you. God. Fucking shut your trap for once. It's like you're trying to make us fight each other again for the fifth fucking time this week. I don't know how much I need to shove it up your ass that I'm not obligated to explain shit to you, don't you trust me? For fuck's sake. I do, Kachin, I really do trust you. But I'm not just gonna stand here and act like you're not hurting my feelings. Katsuki stood silent at the sudden remark, sharp carmine eyes falling soft into his glassy emerald ones. It definitely wasn't the first time Deku decides to snap at him for being such an ass, but Katsuki can't help getting flustered every time he meets his jaw clenching tightly, and pouty lips like an angry puppy. The view was adorable, but he realized the predicament clearly. What? His voice softened, confused because he really hadn't noticed how upset he had been. Never mind. Deku had snapped in front of Katsuki because of the stupid petty thoughts that kept him up at night, leaving him bewildered and angry. And he hadn't meant to do that, but Katsuki somehow just has the capacity to test his patience. Don't do that shit, Deku. You know damn well I don't like it when you leave me hanging onto a cliffhanger like that. It's stupid. What we're fighting about is stupid, I'll leave it be and let you win. Sorry for asking too many questions. He motions his fingers across his lips and seals it shut, the blonde raising one of his eyebrows to observe him properly. What the fuck? Why the hell did he snap at me and let me win at the end? Does he think I can't take him seriously? Oh, yeah. And before you even try saying that you think that I think you can't take me seriously. Don't push it. I'm just tired and if you're taking me out to eat then I'll have it in peace. He marched past Katsuki swiftly, whose mouth was wide open. What the fuck? Shitty hair, I'm going to fucking use you as a punching bag. He grits his teeth as he goes forward on Kirishima only to be blocked by his hardening quirk. Bakugo knows his defenses and goes behind him to kick his back, resulting in the redhead's stomach landing on the floor. He steps on the middle of his back as Kirishima's head smooshes on the mat of the sparring room, leaving him no room to breathe. Be Bakugo. Take a bee breather, bee bro. Kirishima struggles letting out the words properly before getting his head pushed by Bakugo's arms back to the floor. Why you? For real, man. I can't breathe like this. Katsuki was about to lose it when he gets reminded of Deku's glassy eyes when he tries to finish his bowl of ramen quickly. Assessing how tense the atmosphere was from their walk to the restaurant. He had planned it to be at least a decent evening with playful banters, that just somehow had to be ruined. Had it? God, he thought he could understand anything the nerd said and not be an oblivious son of a bitch like back then. These current events just threw off all their progress to trash and it made him anxious. He had gone through so much mixed emotions whenever they were close to each other, not liking anything one bit. Truth is, he has never felt any emotions other than anger. It was always there inside of him and he had never bothered to look past through it. So why now? Why was it whenever he looks at his stupid nerdy face that his heart even thinks of skipping a beat and get all jumpy whenever he was happy? It tortured the hell out of him and he just wished he had never agreed to be friends with the nerd in the first place. He wouldn't have to get nervous every time he made the wrong impression, or tilt his head away from Deku's eyes that were purely showing affection. Whenever Katsuki had to push him away because he couldn't handle the overwhelming emotions, it made him mope inside his room that every slight interaction they had together played inside his mind like a broken record. He was trying, but he clearly has too much self-preservation because whenever he decides to get close, he finds a way to hurt the nerd's feelings. Letting his confidence deteriorate into a pit of disappointment, that wasn't him. He could care less about how people would think of him if he treated them like shit, but soon came to the fact that he only feels that way because they don't matter. And no matter how much his stubborn ass wants to deny it, he's grown far enough to care about the damn nerd, maybe even brave enough to say, like, his opinions of him, his act around him, his feelings for him all mattered to Katsuki for some nonsensical reason and it was leading him into overdrive. Kirishima huffed out another grunt to him as Katsuki got sucked inside his array of thoughts, helping the blonde snap back into reality. He removed his feet from his backbone, grabbing his towel and duffel bag to the shower room, not announcing any goodbyes to the redhead. Dude. What's up with you today? Not of your business, hair for brains. Katsuki lets out, clearly stating how he wants to be left alone and not be interrogated with questions. He was not going to be patient and deal with Deku's bullshit today, he was acting all childish, and upset but making it vague for the blonde to comprehend him properly. It was either they talked about this, or didn't talk at all. The brunette on the other hand, weighed out options to discuss his feelings to Katsuki but a part of himself was insecure and scared that nothing will come out of it, cause if he really was honest, how will he even say it to Kachin? That he was jealous that Kirishima never had to deal with the past that haunts him to this day, that he was jealous Kirishima naturally knows how to lure Katsuki in without making him so pissed off. That he was jealous of the sparring session they have when Kakin pins him on the floor without realizing how awkward the position would look to other people. Yeah, no way he was embarrassing himself like that. Both of them always had ridiculous misunderstandings that couldn't be fixed caused by their thick heads. Someone had to break the ice. But until it was really necessary for them to communicate with each other, they weren't going to make an effort. Mum. Do I really have to go? What's up with you today? You're usually excited whenever anything is related to Katsuki-kun. Is everything alright between the both of you? Yeah, but, no. What's up, honey? We've just had a misunderstanding lately, and you know how we both are. Stubborn and can't find a solution to anything. Yeah, that's right. I know it might seem uncomfortable for you to do this, but you know how Mitsuki practically begs for us to attend. Just for a while, okay? Of course, I'm not gonna let the fight ruin this. I'll try and just avoid him. Izuku, I know how stubborn you both are, but it doesn't hurt to try and approach him. I know he can blow up, but I'm sure he'll tolerate whatever you have in mind. You two seem happy when hanging out together. Maybe. I don't know, Mum. Don't pressure it though, let's just have fun today. Inko pats her son's green locks softly and fixes his attire while he holds onto the present that was wrapped up neatly. It was Kachin's dad's birthday and the last thing he wanted was to ruin the event. He prepared himself before pressing the doorbell of the Bakugo household, part of him wishing he wouldn't be met with a spiky blonde boy in the late afternoon. Luckily God was on his side and he was greeted with a smiling Mitsuki who ushered them inside the house politely. The whiff of curry scurried its way through the halls, and Izuku took notes of the spicy peppers that made his nose scrunch. Kachin was cooking. Masaru grinned at them near the common area, making some small talk with Inko, and an opportunity landed to give the present. He had hesitated to accept it at first, saying there really was no need, but Inko had insisted and said we all should just celebrate. Every year was always like this, the exchangements of gifts between the Bakugos and Midoriyas as their parents were close friends. The juxtaposition between the elders and the kids were obvious. If the parents had agreed to be peaceful to one another, it was the children that had comical problems. It would always create an awkward tension whenever they ate together, but quickly died down when the parents made some jokes they couldn't understand, laughing at it loudly. Parents and their humor. At that moment, Katsuki and Izuku would exchange unsolicited eye contact to each other. Being stubborn about their own opinions, scoffing softly as they chewed harshly on their food. It happened for years. Izuku hoped the dynamics might have changed this year because they talk more now, but I guess that's still far from his expectations. He can only hope to get this day over with and avoid Kakin again. Just like he always did. Right? Katsuki-kun has always been a good cook. I'm glad I get to enjoy it every time we have these little parties. She looks at him with an endearing look and his mother replies. The brat's gotta learn how to compensate for the things we give him, but I'd say you're right for that one. Have you ever taught him how to cook? It's actually a miracle the food he makes tastes like this. Inko finally realizes the words she said, dropping a hand over a mouth and mumbled apologies. I'm not saying you're a bad cook, Mitsuki, it's just. She tilts away from her stern eye contact, not wanting to worsen the situation by making her angry. To her surprise, the married couple both gave a loud chortle. Inko, no need to apologize. That's actually funny because Katsuki does beat his mother's cooking skills. Mitsuki sends a sharp glare at her husband, but her lips still form into a slight smirk. I remember the one time the brat actually scolded me for saying I bought the wrong ingredients, the nerves he has. The useless conversations went on and on, leaving Katsuki poke on his own cutlet getting bored of having no one to talk to, and nothing to do. He looked up at Izuku who sat in front of him, digging in the curry he had cooked and had anticipated a sparkle in his eyes to comment on the taste of the food. Instead, the damn nerd decides to choke on the food because he was dumb. Oh my god, what had Bakugo even expected him to do? Everyone pays attention to him, Mitsuki scolding Katsuki for not having prepared the water on the dining table earlier. Why didn't you bring the goddamn water to the table? Where's your mind at? Go take him to the kitchen and fetch him water. Take him with you to help bring the glasses back here. He grunts at her before moving to Izuku, yanking his arms as he leads them both into the kitchen. Katsuki wondered if his mum had purposefully done that so that he could resolve his problems with Izuku. It made him angry to think that someone had to butt inside his business and make him feel like he can't fix them on his own. He grabs a mug on the cupboard and pours water from a filled bottle nearby. He aggressively hands it over to the boy's hands, Izuku meekly replying a thank you. He scoffs again before commenting. What? You're just too dumb, you choke on your own food now? Izuku's cheeks reddened at the sudden remark, looking away from his direction and chugged on his water. Can't even answer me now? What the hell was his deal? Every time Izuku asks questions it's wrong, but every time he doesn't reply it's also wrong. He stares up at him and leans on the kitchen counter and replies. Can we not do this today? It's your dad's birthday. The last thing I want is for your parents to hear us screaming at each other's throats today. What the hell is up with you? Bakugo snaps back after receiving the snark and sassy reply. Something was definitely up that nerd's ass for him to be acting this way, during the days where they didn't talk, about 2 weeks, which was stupid. He'd been tracing back about the things that made him act like this. Katsuki was absolutely clueless. You know, if you have something to fucking complain about to me, you better just spit it out right now. I don't. Then why the hell is your ass acting like a goddamn toddler? I'm not acting like a toddler. Yeah, explains why you're being so petty over me shouting at you. You know damn well I do that to everyone. And, I'm not mad because of that. So what the hell are you mad about? Huh? God. Every time we don't fight, you just somehow have a talent to ruin things between us and throw all that fucking progress into the trash. I am not the one who ruins things between the both of us. Then are you saying it's my fault? Huh? Is that what you wanted to say? The words spit out his mouth like venom. What they intended to never do to maintain the calmness of the evening was ruined because Deku couldn't shove food down his throat properly. Oh my god, this was driving Katsuki insane. I'm not saying that. Deku gives him a dirty look before scoffing at him loudly. That was it. No, that was. Masaru comes inside the kitchen to check up on them, planning to ask them why they had taken so long to get the cups and water ready. He catches the sight of the two boys grunting at each other, stopping Katsuki's hands that were about to grab the other boy's collar. Katsuki. Masaru chides his son in a soft tone, still stern. The blonde looks at his dad, who obviously had a disappointed expression on his face, signing both of them to stop the banter. I'm so sorry. I hadn't meant for this to happen. I'm really sorry. He bows at Masaru apologetically before leaving the kitchen to go back to his seat. Katsuki being fast enough to grab his wrists and bring them to his room, finishing what they had started. Really, Katsuki? On my birthday too? The blonde grunts back to his dad, unable to look at him in the eye. But he couldn't back down now. The nerd had started a fight, and he had to finish it. Though he says one thing to address the situation hastily. We have shit to talk about, enjoy your afternoon. Masaru just shakes his head in agreement, pointing at them to go and talk about whatever they should. He knew he couldn't stop his son either way. Talk. There's nothing to talk about. There clearly is, because you're acting like a brat. Look, I'm not gonna fucking beg for you to tell me what the hell is going on in your shitty life that makes you act like this, but you're testing my patience. It's like you're trying so hard to ruin this day for the both of us. Me. Wanting to ruin your dad's birthday? For what? What will that even do for me? I don't fucking know. Maybe you just want to get into my nerves and shove it up my ass. I ruined this whole event. It's not my fault you decide to grab me by the collar like that. You were asking for it. No, I wasn't. You're just being an asshole. I know that, you dipshit. What? So you're doing this on purpose? That's not what I meant. Then what do you mean? Look. Oh my god, you fucking dumbass, as much as I hate to admit it. It bothers the hell out of me that you're distancing yourself from me. I don't know the specific reason why. Maybe it's because you're being bitchy for no reason. What? I'm not repeating what I just said. So just spit it the fuck out, because the last thing I want is to make us fight again over something that can be solved by talking. That's weird, you want us to talk. Same person who ignored me for 10 years straight. You wanna fucking go? No. I don't. Cause I'm so tired of embarrassing myself over and over. I can't say anything without you getting mad over it anyway. What? What am I supposed to say? That I'm jealous of how you and Kirishima talk so easily without having to scream at each other like we do? What? Fuck. Are you kidding me? This is what it was about? Horizontal ellipsis. Cat got your tongue? I didn't me. Oh, you fucking meant that, alright. Are you serious? You're jealous over shitty hair? Katsuki was actually short-circuiting inside his head, but maybe it was natural for him to act angry and maintain his image. His heart jumps at the sudden reply, because that was truly unexpected. So the nights he decided to spend moping on something that wasn't even big of a problem was because the damn nerd was jealous over Kirishima. Why the hell? What? See, this is where I'm so confused. Sometimes you can act so gentle to me, which makes me so happy, but then you just blow up on me like how you used to back then. It reminds me of the old times, and I don't understand. I don't understand why you're acting this way, and it's making me mad that I can't read you like your friends can. Okay? I don't know what makes you so mad whenever you look at me. And I know for sure if you compare me with any of your friends, you'd obviously pick them because you guys have way better dynamics than the two of us. It's just that, God. I wish we'd never gone through the past so that I don't have to question myself whether you hate me or not. I want to believe that we're changing for the better, okay? But I can't keep doing it if you're gonna keep being mad at me all the time. I can't fix it because you won't even tell me what's wrong. I told you it was stupid. I just didn't want to talk about it because it actually is nothing. Deku. Now his head was really short-circuiting. He really didn't know what to say. Should he feel happy that Deku felt jealous that Kirishima had more of his attention, or mad at himself for not being able to control his temper till it made Izuku question his own worth? His mind was blank. It's not stupid. I know I'm fucking trying, but clearly it isn't enough to show you that I actually care. Katsuki doesn't know how to say it. He had always felt like he cared more about his opinions more than anyone else. He wouldn't be dealing with this shit if he didn't. And if there's one thing that disturbed him so much was that for all his life, he knows Midoriya Izuku is a constant. Even if everything staggers and shakes and changes, he would always be there. No matter how bad, no matter how good. All of the important moments in Katsuki's life he had been there to give him praise for whatever remarkable thing he'd do. His green eyes would light up with excitement, calling out in the most chipper tone, "Kachin. Suboi." That was what made him shake up in fear and disgust, because really, when everyone saw Katsuki as someone great, Izuku had found him as an equal. He had been the person who stuck to him his whole life. Kindergarten, elementary, junior high, and no, high school. Izuku had always admired him, and oh my god, as much as Katsuki wanted to deny it, he wouldn't want Izuku to ever hate him. If everything in his life changes, and there was no more Deku chasing him to conquer the number one spot, he wouldn't be able to find a ground where he can stand on. Deku was his constant, his last constant, and it would be the last thing he wanted to have the green-haired boy shoot hateful glares at him, like he'd never gone through a phase where Deku found him as the hero he thought he would never be. They weren't just friends, they weren't just former childhood rivals. Deku wasn't that bony kid Katsuki mocked in junior high, and Katsuki wasn't that bully that took advantage of his quirk to push people around. They've evolved from that phase, and he would hate to see everything shatter down again. Deku, fuck. You're my constant. I know that it doesn't even make sense that I'm saying this. But really, you're the only thing that's been there from me since day one. Everyone changed, everyone managed to leave, I ruined All Might, I got kidnapped by the League of Villains, which was fucking stupid, I have these stupid emotions that aren't anger. God. Everything fucking changes, and you're the only thing that stayed with me throughout all of that fucking painful situation. Okay? I don't know how to say it. But it'd hurt me more than anything to see you hate me. Like you just totally went obsessing over me like you used to. Fuck, you're just there, okay? You're always fucking there no matter how much I try to push your ass away. And the more I do push you away, it gets harder every single time. I don't understand why. I don't. But what you do need to know is that we can't be explained into words, okay? We're just difficult and different, and that I care about you no matter how much of an asshole I become, and I don't want you to leave, I don't want you to hate me. Kachin. He notices the way Katsuki had put his hand between his head on the wall as he screamed, trapping Izuku and his shorter figure. The green-haired boy's heart had skipped a beat, smelling the sweat that was dripping down his neck from the strong agitation. He was able to understand him a little more now, at least. I'm going to fucking try this again, no matter how much you push me away. If you're able to stick beside me for all those years I ignored you, then I'd make a much bigger effort to never let you slip away from my hands again. Thank you.